So, as of recent tournament history, we have seen that Prank Kids, after its win at YCS Milan, is not just another world legacy. Instead, Prank Kids is actually one of the top decks now, being able to take 3 slots out of the top 16 of ARG Orlando. And while that might not seem that impressive, you also have to take into consideration the other 2 best decks were Thunder Dragons that also had 3 slots, and Sky Strikers at 5 slots. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about Prank Kids a little bit more and why it's actually the most fair meta combo deck of 2018. And in this video, I'm also going to give a history of meta combo decks this year. So to understand why Prank Kids is the most fair meta combo deck of 2018, we have to take a look back at the rest of this year. Why has this year been full of more unfair meta combo decks? Well, to start, we should talk about the big 3 meta combo decks this year, which were Spiral, Pendulum Magicians, and Goki. Or I guess you can also classify Dark Warrior, but that's besides the point. So this year has been full of very degenerate combo strategies. The first one of this year was Spiral. Spiral was a great combo deck at first, but at full power when it took up 29 out of 32 slots of YCS Dallas, and then just dominated the format until we needed an emergency ban list because it was so powerful. Why was Spiral so powerful? Well, it was by far the best combo deck, and it was very degenerate, being able to set up a Trigate, a Firewall, and a Spiral Sleeper, being very hard to break for most decks. This deck was just a league above the rest and could OTK very easily. So with that, we got our emergency ban list, and Spiral adapted and became still a very good combo deck. It was by far the best combo deck, and even though it evolved into a going second combo deck, either way, you were basically guaranteed to win. And Spiral going second, regardless of it going second and not setting up an insane board going first, was still just so degenerate that it didn't matter. So after Spiral was hit, 3 days earlier, we actually got Metal Foes Electromite, which by far made Pendulum Magicians the best deck. This card was so powerful as it could get you access to any pendulum in your deck, or just any pendulum for that matter. This card in tandem with Astrograph Sorcerer was so degenerate, as Astrograph Sorcerer was able to be a free body and then would also get you a search. As well, Electromite would get you access to another one and another one, and overall, because Electromite wasn't a hard once per turn, and because the only hard once per turn effect was its draw effect, this card was heavily abused. This card was also heavily abused with Starving Venom in order to generate even more resources and use those Starving Venoms for rank 8 plays. Electromite's ease of use, ease of access, accessibility, and versatility overall made Pendulum Magician so much better, making Astrograph Sorcerer so much more viable, and just was so powerful that this deck was just absurd. There were multiple ways to play the deck. You could play a more passive variant that uses hand traps and sets up 2 disruptions and maybe a hand trap as well. You can set up a quote-unquote Triff or Adderall variant of Pendulum that actually was originated by Triff Gaming. Stick to the game plan, am I right? But Triff invented this Adderall variant of Pendulum that basically says, I will spam the field with a bunch of negates and try to break it. Usually you could set up 3 to 4 negates very easily with this variant of the deck. You could also play the FTK variant, which would be able to FTK your opponent highly consistently. And just overall, there are so many ways to play Electromite and Pendulum Magicians that it was very good. And just, you could do so much. But either way, out of all these variants, the main theme is that they were all very degenerate combo strategies and could be hard to play through. The only deck that could play through all this was maybe True Draco, but that's because True Draco was a very powerful control deck. And even then, True Draco lost to the FTK variant, so it was a trade-off. However, in the end of all of this, we also had another combo deck with Goki. The introduction of Flames of Destruction heavily changed everything with the introduction of the Nightmares, finally making Goki a viable strategy. It was a matter of time before this strategy could be viable, and the Nightmares were just what the deck needed, providing such utility and ease of use, and enabled the deck to extra lane. Along with a Trigate negate. However, here's the thing. This was a two-card combo deck that could do this combo very efficiently with cards like Firewall Dragon, etc. It could OTK very easily, and overall was just a very degenerate strategy as well, just because of the extra link. However, this strategy evolved over time regardless of the ban list, because we had even more degenerate link monsters be introduced, for example, Summon Sorceress and Gumblar Dragon. So this would eventually turn into just an extra link with one negate, which could still be broken. It's not like it was impossible to break, but it still was very hard to break, and most of the time you would have to go to game two. But when we had Gumblar Dragon to our disposal and Summon Sorc, this just made the deck more consistent and more dangerous, eventually leading to this deck being absurd and way too degenerate, and by far the most degenerate combo deck of this year. We finally had Firewall Dragon ban, which helped reduce the degeneracy of this deck, but we still have it in the form of Dark Warrior, and Goki variants still exist. But now those decks focus around turboing out Rongo Nemiad with 5 materials or 6 materials turn 1 and killing the opponent the next turn. This is a much more fragile variant of the strategy, however that doesn't mean that it's bad, and combo decks have just been so degenerate throughout the year. My point is, this makes a very unfair game, essentially saying if I win the die roll, I win the match, because I can set up an unbreakable board turn 1, and no matter what you do, I just win the match. Compared to other combo decks of the past, like for example Metalfoes and DDDs, these combo decks of 2018 are so much more degenerate. You could play through these boards that DDDs and Metalfoes could make, however you can't necessarily do that when you have to discard 4 cards and deal with an extra link along with the Trigate negate. A few key things happened since these combo decks became so degenerate, however, that essentially helped reduce the degeneracy. One thing, the most important thing, is the ban list. The ban list has had to do some serious damage to these combo decks, including banning Firewall and Nightmare Goblin, banning Astro and limiting Electromite, and limiting Resort, Quick Fix, and Drone. Along with other hits, Konami has really had to hammer down on these combo strategies, and yet they still exist regardless because there are so many moving pieces. Next, Konami needed to release more fair combo decks that could compete with other meta decks. By the way, when I say fair, I'm saying it's not degenerate, and you're still able to play the game regardless of losing the die roll. Extra links meant you can't play the game, and you had to rely on luck in order to beat combo decks, assuming you lost the die roll. So why are prank hits fair? Well, like I've described, you can still play the game even if prank hits win the die roll. Prank hits can set up a quick play Raigeki or Heavy Stormduster or 2 Raigeki if need be. This is much easier to play through, however, than playing through an extra link and discard 4, and a negate. By no means is this the easiest board to break, however, by no means you automatically lose the game when you face a prank kids board, and in turn makes it a much more fair match. However, the reason why prank kids are meta at this point is because they're a combo deck that can resource so efficiently. Think about it, every monster floats into another one from your deck, and you get extra value when you link with them, etc. And the link monsters get you a lot of value, the fusion monsters reborn the link monsters, so overall there's a lot of moving pieces that really gives this deck a lot of playability in order to resource very efficiently, and in turn, making it very viable. If you say this deck isn't meta, I would have to disagree considering the results we've been getting as of recent, from regionals and the ARG Orlando event that happened a little bit ago, like I mentioned earlier in the video. There were quite a bit of prank kids in that event, so with that, I would consider prank kids to be meta. Overall, I'm happy to see less degeneracy in the game with combo decks, and hopefully the trend continues in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, I hope you enjoyed. If you guys want to support me further than just watching my YouTube videos, go down into the description and support me on Patreon. It helps out quite immensely. As well, if you guys want to talk to me and other members of the community further than just the YouTube comment section, go down into the description and join my Discord server. I'd love to have you guys there. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and with that, I'll see you soon.